Hey guys, what is up? Iron Reaper 92, and today we are going to be continuing playing Tales of Berseria. Now, we fixed the little glitch last time, so we're running in full speed now. Thank God. But I really enjoyed playing this a couple of weeks ago, and I figured, hey, why not, you know, actually play a little bit more of it. So, I think we're still in the tutorial here. It's a beautiful game. I'm really liking everything so far, except how slow the battles and stuff were, but apparently that was a little bit of a glitch because of the engine that the game's running in. So if any of you guys have that problem with the game running in slow-mo, check what you've got your GPU clocked at for FPS. Like, if you have it set to work at 60, the game sometimes comes in and it's defaulted down to, I believe, 30. So you have to reset it to try to run 60, otherwise it'll run in slow motion. Just something to check out if you guys have that problem, but anyways.
Nico, here for groceries?
Yep, and you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner.
If you were a boy,
I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah?
You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh, what is wrong with Midgand?
I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
Velvet! You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious?
Please, this is life or death for me. But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
People think.
The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right.
Luffy must be starving by now. I'd better hurry home.
Orthy and Russ seem pretty dead.
I know. They've been whimpering like this for an hour now.
Well, they've always been a bit wimpy. The other day, that kitty Rollo chased both of them up a...
There, hope, Orthy.
They're completely hopeless.
Maybe.
But they're so cute. So I forgive them.
All right, it looks like we have to go this way. I feel like this is a game you would like more than me, Lika. It is so girly so far.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried.
Drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the cape tomorrow.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Luffy, I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Luffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... 20 years, tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh, yeah? You better prove it to me, then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove. It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know, but just for today?
Fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once, and I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet.
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there?
God, I actually have to go find it.
There you go. Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious. Oh yeah, I saw Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah. We've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
Hmm, You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. Oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men, I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong?
Oh, wrong one. Damn it.
Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy, that's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready.
I have a feeling they're just going to do the typical RPG thing and have something horrible happen. Okay, there's two things over here I've got to get. Are they upstairs? It's not really giving me very many hints here. So I lit the fire. Begin cooking. Oh, you got to go over here. I'm guessing this is going to be one of those games where everybody dies right after the tutorial or something.
Good boy. You didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet? May I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course. Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? To the village alone. I bet your fever hasn't even gone down. Hey, has Lafayette been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait, that's one of Arthur's.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand?
Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet! I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay? He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest. I know. He might have gone to the cape to pick flowers.
Oh, I gotta run all the way back through this again. Ooh, enemies. Nice.
Right, here goes!
Ow. No. Oh shit, it's actually somewhat challenging whenever it's actually running at full speed. That is nice.
Not bad.
That's a hell of a lot better than it was.
Fluffy!
Velvet, can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the cape, then.
Hooray!
Let's see, this way.
Sorry.
Bless you, you alright?
Yeah.
Oh, there's an item. There's an item. Let's get that. Oh, I see, I can't get up there from there, so I gotta go around this way.
Right, here goes!
Damn it! Alright, what was the guard button again? I don't fucking know. It's been a minute since I played this.
Is that all?
Well, I guess I'm gonna have to relearn combat in this game.
Right, here goes!
Alright, there's block. Jesus.
Not bad.
Yeah, combat's definitely gonna take some getting used to. Another item. Well, at least it's not too boring. At least I get to fight my way back through.
Is that all?
Alright, let's see. There's a chest here. I already got that. I don't know why it's still showing up on the screen. I guess we'll save our game real quick before we go up here. I feel like they're just about to completely ruin the entire story of the game like they do in every Tales series. Alright, save data has been overwritten.
Just look at all these. This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to... A demon! Lafayette, run! No matter how much it hurts, run! Velvet!
Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't! Go! Why is a demon here? I don't want to go alone!
You have to! Don't let your feelings get in the way, or that
Zero.
Thing will kill you too! But please, go! Arthur said,
I have to do this! Stop! Face me, demon!
Get home.
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Oh shit, he's Mythos. Just kidding. Oh, she was dreaming, wasn't she?
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream?
No, it wasn't!
Alright, what am I supposed to do now? Typical Tales game.
What on earth is going on? This is no time to be scared.
Did it turn all the townspeople into...
Luffy.
Oh, nope, they're just all dead.
No. The village.
They made them just slower than me so I can run faster than them. Jesus. Yep, everybody's dead. Nice. Totally saw this coming.
Don't give up. Never give up.
I can't fight these damn things, can I? I don't know how to run from combat, so. I guess we're just gonna have to run from them. Alright, hopefully that damn thing isn't still chasing me by the time... Oh, no. They give up pretty easy. Alright, let's save real quick. Oh, this is gonna be a long-ass episode. I gotta get through the tutorial, though, at least. So what do you think of it so far, Lika?
Alright.
That's alright. It's kind of generic.
Luffy! Arthur!
And this is where we figure out Arthur's the bad guy. I don't know. I'm just guessing.
You...
Oh, thank goodness. You kept Luffy safe, too.
Pretty obvious, though.
One more sentiment to cast off.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight... Here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lopisek's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you will not change. Ever a slave to emotion.
We actually get a cutscene. That's nice.
Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorias Colbrand, will end your pain. Is it that birds fly? Behold my answer, Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
Finally leveled up. Well, this has been one hell of a long episode, so I guess I'm going to end it here. We'll come back and play some more again next time. Thank you guys for watching. And I guess Merry Christmas. I'm probably going to post this today, so Merry Christmas, everybody. We'll see you guys in the next video.